Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to discuss the retinoblastomas. So particularly we are concerning the discussion or we are narrowing down the discussion towards the retinal tumors, and the most notorious tumor that is involving the retina is the retinoblastoma. It's again one of the major primary ocular tumors that we're talking about, the most prevalent and the most commonly occurring tumor. So first of all, we'll just outline the classification that is related to the retinoblastoma over here. What are the different sorts of classification ranging from the Rees-Ellsworth classification? And then we have another classification that is based upon the severity of the disease. Once you have classified the disease, we are going to move on to the different stages of this carcinoma. It can be a benign condition, as well as it can advance on to a more malignant kind of a retinoblastoma. Then we're going to furthermore discuss the different management or the treatment guidelines that are particularly related to the retinoblastoma conditions. It would be ranging from the chemotherapies, what are the particular chemotherapeutic agents that are inculcated for the treatment of these retinoblastomas or these hereditary tumors that are also notoriously known as. So we'll be ranging from the ones we can also just relate to the chemotherapy of these patients. And sometimes we are inculcated or we are bound to perform focal therapy for these patients. So what would be the initial focal therapies ranging from the laser photocoagulations or the other grid treatments that are inculcated for the focal therapies or of much benign kind of these malignant tumors. Then we have the enucleations. Enucleation is basically regarded as the complete excision of the eyeball. So obviously it's not quite recommended in all of the cases, but if it's a malignant condition that has also the direct extensions to the other cavities, for example, the nasal cavity or either the cranial cavities, that can be quite debilitating. You may also need to perform these enucleations in these patients. And after these enucleations, obviously you're going to move on to the prosthetic eyes that are sometimes inculcated for these patients. So we'll be discussing all of this over here in this lecture, and then we'll be moving on to the phacomatosis. Phacomatosis is basically a group of rare syndromic conditions that sometimes arise, and usually they are the oculocentral and dermatological conditions. So these are basically the three major components of this disease, which is known as the phacomatosis. Usually they are the syndromic babies having the external facial features that are quite typical, and one should know how to deal with these patients and how to manage these infants as well. So there is a range of ophthalmopathies that are being discussed on our website. And thanks for watching sqadia.com, and to get the access to watch the complete lectures.